And look, Powerslide is going to block. He's going to block to keep his ally alive. Nuclear is stopped. Now Rhino tries to sneak past, and he gets past Powerslide.
But that might be too little too late, and Powerslide doing a great job getting around by Lusik, almost taken out. There might be enough. It might be enough.
World of Tanks tournaments do have a special type of place in my heart because they are different compared to what we see from other games.
They know he's around here somewhere. 6 seconds left. Can Sib hide? 4, 3, there he's found! 2, 1, will he go down? He gets a tracking shot and he survives.
Every esports title has its own unique features and you have to treat it differently. And World of Tanks is very special because we have 7 players.
1v1, 3 seconds left.
I've never really played a game like World of Tanks. It's very different from any other esport.
Playing with each other, aiming so low, it's down to...
Это огромная выдержка, куча тренировок и моральная подготовка к играм.
So the rears of these Pershings, they are going to try and take them both down. Butcher needs one more shot, he'll go down, but Blue Boy's captain is on reload. He survives, somehow Blue Boy's maximum is still alive. And this is disastrous from Levin Train as they go down and we've only got 2 combat tanks left. What a play there by Sib, but...
You are the best of the best world's esports, you know, champions. Thank you very much.
The history of World of Tanks esports has its roots back in 2010. It all started with amateur tournaments, whose winners received in-game gold. Since then, many things have changed. In 2011, the 742 format was introduced and has remained as the main esports format ever since.
So with the 7-on-7 format, it's more players on the field. And with that, you have more strategies, you have more differences within the strategies, and you have a lot more fun sometimes with what these individual personalities can bring to the sport itself.
Each team consists of 7 tanks. The tanks are worth their tier in points and can be any tier 8 tank or below. The IS-3, for example, is tier 8 and thus worth 8 points. The total points for a team cannot exceed 42. At the moment, it's common for teams to have 5 tier 8 tanks for 40 points and 2 tier 1 tanks for a combined total of 42.
Are there differences in terms of the playability or the difficulty? There can be. This is not a Twitch-based game compared to an RTS or other games where, depending on how fast you can move, that's how good you are. This is based more on team strategy and team synergy.
The format gained its popularity very quickly. The game developers noted the players' interest in it, and in 2012, they opened an esports department. That very year, the first international tournament was held. But the main event that year was the World of Tanks debut at what was the world's greatest esports championship at the time, the World Cyber Games.
I've been working in the world of esports for almost 4 years, and I have worked behind the scenes and also in front of the scenes as a host and a commentator. And I started working with World of Tanks in 2012. I was a commentator for the World Cyber Games Grand Finals in Kunshan, China, where I got to meet a lot of the players and teams that are still participating in World of Tanks today.
The year 2013 was a milestone. It was decided to organize the World of Tanks Global League. The tournament was unprecedented for World of Tanks in terms of scale. In 1 year, over 40,000 teams from all over the world took part in 3 seasons of the Wargaming League. The competitions were held in 6 clusters: Russian, European, North American, Chinese, Korean, and Asian. The total prize pool was $2.5 million, and the total amount of investments, $8 million. But the greatest motivator for the teams was surely participation in the final tournament, the Grand Finals. The tournament took place from the 4th to the 6th of April in Warsaw, Poland.
I think that the reasons behind choosing Poland as the hosting country for World of Tanks, well, it's really simple. I think that World of Tanks has a huge fan base here in Poland. The community is absolutely crazy.
The best teams in the world came to the Polish capital with one aim: to fight for the title of the undisputed champion of World of Tanks.
It is already a challenge to organize the stage for 7 players, enough PCs, organize the travel for 7 players. So for that only one point, it's very different. Also, like, the game itself, when it starts, is really fast.
The players were offered ideal living conditions. All expenses for traveling and stay were covered by the organizers. The tankers were free from all the organizational problems and could focus exclusively on their game.
Such event is always a great venture, which requires a lot of people from different expertise. I think that overall, just during the setup and the event it's in teardown, it's almost 300 people, just to make it work.
The players were accommodated within 5 minutes walking distance from the event venue. The tournament was held in the Poland capital's city center, the commercial and entertainment complex Złote Tarasy. In order to ensure the event spectators great viewing conditions, a whole cinema hall was rented for the event.
This venue in particular is very difficult to work with. I mean, it wasn't designed for events like that, which means we have to always deal with these minor difficulties that make life very difficult. That's like starting from the unloading points.
The final games were broadcast live simultaneously in 6 languages, so that fans from all regions could enjoy most of their favorite team's games.
As much as we love to watch sports on television, we also like to see our favorite players and how they react to interviews and what do they say. Sometimes we have favorite commercials they're in. And to me, that's part of the human element that is so crucial for us as an audience to connect to someone. I've never been a pro basketball player. I've never been a pro baseball player. But I can connect to those athletes if they have a story to tell. And I can root for them when I know that story, and I can connect with them and be a fan of them. And I feel that's very, very important.
The prize pool of the grand finals was $300,000, and over $100,000 was taken by the winners. But let's review the event from start to finish. The final tournament was attended by 14 teams, the best two from every region.
I'm feeling pretty good, excited, and hopefully, or hoping that I'm going to do well.
Эмоции отлично. Перелет был качественным, легким, простым, очень агрессивным. Будем сражаться, показывать интересные матчи, бои и вообще порадуемся.
I feel honored that I'm here with all the hotel and the limo. Yeah.
Прибыли на гранд-финал, все хорошо. Полет прошел неплохо. Что, будем побеждать?
You think I'm scared of Na'Vi? Na'Vi is only known in the gaming community, but Batman and Robin, they're known in the whole universe. They should be scared of us.
Plus, two teams received a special invitation from the organizers. They were the European champions of WCG 2013, the German team, Vusa, and one of the best European teams, the Lemming Train.
We trained quite a lot, more than usual, and we also played quite a lot against the teams.
We are in Poland, so we will try to kick their ass. We will not be a very nice team for our enemies, so we just want to win.
The competition was held in 2 halves. The first half took the 2 invited teams, as well as the teams who took second place in their regional leagues. These 8 teams were divided into 2 groups and fought each other using the double elimination system.
We will use the double elimination system for the sake of fairness. If a strong team faces another strong team, someone has to lose the game, and we wouldn't like them to leave the tournament this quickly, so they will have a second chance.
Generally speaking, it's a system that's very similar to football playoffs, with one significant difference. The losing team in football is always out of the competition, while with double elimination, each team has a second chance.
The weaker teams will also have a really good opportunity to play more games and against teams from other regions.
Every match of the grand finals included several battles. A victory in a game gave the winners 1 point. In case of a draw, both teams got 1 point.
Everything is done for the fans, to provide them with exciting matches, to show them some dynamic and exciting tank warfare.
The first team to get 2 points was declared the winner of the match. If both opponents got these points simultaneously, an additional round was declared. Assault on Sand River. The second half of the event was only for the group winners and the regional league champions. These 8 finalists played following the same double elimination rules, though here, the matches were played till someone got 3 points instead of 2. So let's jump to the start of the first day of the grand finals.
Clock Global Grand Finals Live from Warsaw, Poland.
Дорогие танкисты, всем доброго дня. В общем, мы живы, все хорошо, мы здесь. Ну, давайте переключимся на сцену, как говорится, go to stage.
Can just hide away. Can he hide long enough, though? Applewell has been found. Nears Pezzoni finds it. One man now stands. It's just positive. And surely he's been taken down. Lemming Train.
We won. We are so happy. We are proud that the crowd just... We are what was with us, and because of them, we also won. It was easier for us.
They got the final shot on the final second for them to get the win, and I felt that was a huge momentum build.
He's going to have to reset. There's 4 seconds left. This could be going to... Oh, my God, he doesn't hit the shot. The clock has run down.
We just lost the tiebreaker against Synergy. One thing for sure is just bad luck.
The next battle is going to be You Are Dead versus Red Rush Unity.
То, что там у них внутри, это просто пожар. Это да, я говорил, что горела жара.
Я считаю, что нам помогла огромная выдержка, куча тренировок и очень хорошая моральная подготовка к турниру.
I'm just proud that this event is here. It's amazing. It's really amazing.
This is for Lemming Train to walk away with a Stalker up against Snip 1v1. 3 seconds left. He got the shot. He reset it. It was just about time. Toying with each other. Alien so low. It's down to one. He's done it. He's done it for Lemming Train.
Эмоции, конечно, на дне. Мы очень разочарованы своими результатами, потому что планировали минимум выйти в полуфинал.
We are now celebrating. Tomorrow we'll be thinking about what to do against Aretha, against Na'Vi, probably.
This is the time to show Noah team, show the strengths to the world.
There's 3 tags now remaining for Noah. It's surely a done deal. It's 2. Only R2L and Chiapapa left. There's nothing that can set R2L moving in. Chiapapa trying to work. He's been held in place. And Red Rush Unity are seconds away from the victory as R2L is surrounded by the opponents. Very little to do but die. Ram from either side. And they are Unity. They've done the victory. Serious faces are on here.
Просто когда ты считаешься фаворитом, играть куда сложнее, когда ты считаешься аутсайдером.
Gentlemen, hell of a day one so far for the World of Tanks Global Grand Finals. Any closing words from day one?
Like the Group A, it was a brilliant game. And LTR has been building up the momentum, and I'm really waiting to see how far it will bring them. Unity didn't look that strong, but we'll see. How will they stop us tomorrow?
I think they're gonna get their heads in the right position. I think they're gonna be great tomorrow.
I have to say, we are stunned. We are honored and unbelievably happy that so many players come to join the best teams in the world to celebrate and have a good time.
Так, порой день гранд-финала, лучшие танковые коллективы готовы сегодня включаться в борьбу, настроены Na'Vi, настроены были с утра Virtus.pro.
Ждем в гранд-финале, как по традиции, с лузеров Na'Vi.
Я думаю, у нас отличный шанс выиграть турнир.
I don't think there's anybody we're really scared of. I don't think anybody really wants to face Na'Vi to start out, but we've got a pretty good seed. We're happy with how we are, and we're just interested in playing the best and seeing how we measure up and getting as far as we can.
Nagatron is on his side, and at the front, Hugo, Jackie, and Friction are powering him down. He goes down, Britain comes in behind, and OYB is not far behind, but it doesn't matter. The damage here from these guys is just superb. The concentrated firepower, nothing stands in the way.
We are here as a part of Grand Finals, World of Tanks, and we are happy to take part in this tournament.
Yeah, they certainly are, and well, they're going to find him, so he is down, so both tier 1s are lost for Unity, but the main battle may commence any second now. Arty has taken a shell, but most of the damage has been done towards Virtus.pro here.
Тактики всегда есть, но все зависит, с кем ты играешь и какая ситуация в игре. Ты можешь победить или не можешь победить. Если ты фаворит, то ты играешь аккуратно.
1v1. First shot will land for Bishop. And now Lucio is in trouble. He's trying to get away. He's trying to dodge these shells coming back at him. But there's only so much room to run to as he has 2 players literally hunting him down.
Что сказать? Проиграли. Допустили немного ошибок.
We feel prepared for the grand finals, but we're not sure if we can
a win, but yeah, we'll try our best.
Well, let's see if he can do anything here. He's going head first. Torgi holds the place. Nice work coming out from Arete there. But look at the clock. 10 seconds to 14. This is so close. Reset's coming in left, right, and center. 10 seconds left. Nils Pizzorni now wants his chances. He's going to come through. Find Sod. Take Sod down.
We need to win. So we do this. With you, we can do everything.
We are going to play against Natus Vincere, one of the best, probably the best esports team in World of Tanks.
We're preparing a lot for this tournament. The Lemon Crank is not bad team, and we ready to win it.
Materius, though, is in trouble. He's got four players staring him down. He's been decimated. Butcher, next target, going low. He's left on a slither of health. Has to back away. 40 HP. Alien still low. Nils Pizzorni into trouble. Oh, Butcher has been wiped off the face of this map. And this is Na'Vi. Clinical, calm, collected, and just decimating them.
Wataku!
Будем надеяться, что у Fnatic есть план по борьбе с одной из самых сильных команд
дисциплины
World of Tanks.
Перш и 90-х много.
Actually, the counter-attack has started as Vorksic moves in against Soviets and Nagatron and Friction, as Soviets on the retreat. So the capture would have been the only chance here, and they decided not to get it. They hit Bishop in the back. He needs one more shot to take him out, but Soviet, it'd be very unlucky that he'll be able to get out of there.
Of course, we think we can win, because we are in winners final, but Na'Vi and Red Rush Unity are still very strong teams, so it will be difficult for us.
In the other side of it, though, the IS-3s are deciding to engage, but he's been gone, he got trapped. That's disastrous, and Dido wins on the other side.
We are sad that we lose, but yesterday we showed the great games. Today we also showed some entertaining, so it's just great for everybody who was here and for esports in God.
Two shells, one more. He will not be able to get the kill unless he puts him on fire.
And Jackie's and just about doesn't. Reloaded.
Jackie's reloaded, but he has to get out of there. But wait, Batman again, he gets the kill.
Being a part of the grand finals is simultaneously just a great achievement and an honor for us. We've been working towards it for over a year now, and we just couldn't be happier that we actually made it and that we're here and we got first seed from our country. So. Overall, just happy to be here.
It's all up to the cap. Nagatron has to kill one of these guys. Aswerda is the guy that he needs to kill. But is he spotted? The answer is no. He aims at a free hit, but he misses. And he goes down. That's it. PvP Super Friends have taken out Fnatic. They're going through to Unity. Look at Batman kicking his computer over in excitement.
I'm just leaving it for the moment. All I want to do is play tanks. We are playing the best esports alive here. Woo!
Вообще, что это было?
Да, Батман? Да, 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 еще раз.
We got it, we got it. We just pulled together and we won. We're very excited right now.
America is out, Southeast Asia is in, and since they've secured the fourth spot, their next opponent tomorrow is going to be the Red Rush Unity.
Somehow, I'm gonna have to watch the replay. I'm still not sure how. We lose. That's it. That's it. RNG. We lose.
I'm excited to wait tomorrow and see the rest of the games. Really big, good tournament so far, so I'm really excited to wait tomorrow.
Yeah, tomorrow, I think we'll see the best of the best.
Всего 4 игры завтра, самые интересные, самые сочные, 3 команды, представляющие наш кластер и супердрузья. Ну вот еще раз, ребят, вам здравствуйте. Наконец-то нас также показали. Мы готовы. Идите за чаем, зовите друзей, включайте на плазму. Это будет фантастический день.
I think we will see some replays and we will try to show something new.
We crush them all.
Strike is so low, he's gone down. Just one man standing. Inspira, Na'Vi are in trouble. Na'Vi have got everything to do here. Inspira is left in a 1v3. And Virtus Pro, they've done the damage, they've done the job, and they have sent Na'Vi to the lower bracket.
Построим в порядке, разберем ошибки, маленько успокоимся.
Ну, честно говоря, какие-то смешанные эмоции, потому что очень много подарков с одной и с другой стороны. И сумбурный матч, пока я еще не осознал до конца, что это было.
I can't really say we're going first, second, third, or fourth, but anything is possible here.
And I look forward to seeing the careers of PvP Super Friends continue to grow in the Southeast Asia regen. He's not going for the ram, he's going to go around the back, and he gets the advantage as Lusik misses a show, but Hydrex misses the next show. It's now even, and he needs to get the shot off first. This is down to the wire. Hydrex might be able to pull this off. No! Lusik gets it with a sliver of health. Unity take it out. That was to the wire. What is it, 20 HP for Unity, but Unity win.
I have to thank my team. They're very good. I have to thank the crowd. Everyone was cheering for us, yeah. And hopefully we can do better in the next tournament.
В следующий раз, возможно, Бэтмен с командой будет уже намного сильнее, и они отомстят Red Rush Unity. Осталось две игры.
Всего лишь две игры.
Virtus.pro, Na'Vi, Red Rush Unity. Сейчас мы узнаем, кто как, вот какое место займет и чем все закончится. Ну что ж, друзья, все-таки все готово к началу боя. Надеюсь, вы тоже готовы.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is how you play World of Tanks, especially when you're under a lot of fire.
And look, Powerslide is going to block. He's going to block to keep his ally alive. Nuclear is stopped. Now Rhino tries to sneak past, and he gets past Powerslide.
But that might be too little too late, and Powerslide doing a great job getting around by Nuseek, almost taken out. There might be enough. It might be enough.
There is one tier 8, and I think he has 499 hit points. He cannot be one shot by one of these Azeris. He needs to be shot twice and he's done.
Draw. Power Slide save the team. Wow.
Стоило немножко догадаться пару игрокам, что нужно кое-что сказать, и было бы все хорошо. По нашей ошибке мы проиграли.
Могу сказать только одно. Эти парни очень классно играли. Где-то не повезло, где-то ошиблись.
Сыграли как, ну не буду говорить слово, но мы сыграли как именно оно. В каждом бою совершали огромное количество ошибок. Ну, плохо сыграли очень.
And so we have to say congratulations to Red Rush Unity on that placement and best of luck.
Да, теперь уже непосредственно о Virtus.pro и Na'Vi.
This is it. For all the marbles, for all the jewels, for all the pride in the world when it comes to World of Tanks, two teams remain. One representing the EU cluster, the EU region, the other representing Russia.
Все, понеслась.
Поехали, первый бой гранд-финала.
Это может быть драка на горе, между делом есть такой процентик.
Ну, на рудниках в первую очередь Virtus.pro использовали какой-то очень странный сетап. Я так подозреваю, что так как они имели преимущество в одно очко, они хотели сыграть от дефа.
Virtus.pro, we've got the double T, AMX5100, the 416, double AMX3090 and the T69 played by Breakneck. So interesting that Virtus.pro decided to choose this side.
Через несколько минут, когда мы поняли расстановку противника, мы заняли центр.
Дальше гоним, гоним!
Стопнул его.
Займите сверху, сверху.
Стоп, стоп, стоп.
Хорош! Eclipse Gold!
Назад левша, назад левша, назад.
Хорош!
Не спеши,
Инск. 2-3 старых, там пульчик.
Вот так хватит тебе. Все, сам нормально.
Ну, в общем, там для Virtus.pro, ну, все очень плохо было. У нас был действительно очень тяжелый сетап, и мы действительно без препятствий потихоньку продавили на центре их.
There is nothing to do but run for the last man alive here, and what a start for Na'Vi.
Энс был совершенно классической расстановкой. Мы заняли совершенно свою стандартную расстановку в городе. Это была не дефовая, не защитная, это был дефолт.
So guys tuning in right now, the north side will be Na'Vi. In the south is Virtus.pro. It is one all. First of all, Virtus.pro didn't pick up a map just yet. They came into this with the advantage of being from the upper side of this tournament.
После этого мы быстро заняли город.
Все, давайте, собраны, парни, попадаем и убиваем. Просто делаем 2-0 и спокойно играем до конца.
They won all their way through here. So now Na'Vi are on a bit of a roll, and we're seeing a bit of an interesting start from both of these.
И в минуту 40 мы стали на захват в 2-1 и 50-100.
Well, they're gonna try. Powerslide is moving in, as is Deluxe, as is Eclipse. Lovshar and Inspira in cover, but one shell does come in, not really connecting perfectly. Deluxe.
Назад, левша.
Сейчас живи, левша.
В углу так. В углу так, без трех.
Ты первый.
Ай, Кирилл, страйк! Я в атаку!
Страйк срочно!
Стань параллельно мне!
Живи!
Цены! Половы 50-100!
Все, выживаем! Сотками! Тройка, 7 еще!
Не получилось! Выживай, Кирилл!
Живи, Кирилл! Первый уедь! Страйк, живи просто!
Страйк, убегай, да!
Кирилл, уедь!
Да не, он не уедет! Зря ты поехал, Кирилл! Ну, блин, мы говорим... Хорошо, блин, ну ты зря поехал.
Эклипс просто вот эти клипсы, виляй и живи.
Оттянули в конце страйка, он засейвился. И по истечению времени это стало ничьей.
20 секунд, мы должны успеть. Главное, не сгори.
А ты можешь вот это?
Хорош. Вот справа там дом. Лучше даже вперед дай за цель и на каток сможет. Значит, так, нормально.
Все норм.
Every single second this is gonna hurt Strike, his heart will be pounding, he must stay alive.
Прохоровка, мы использовали 3 средних танка и 2 MX-1390. Никак провести атаку мы не могли вообще, поэтому мы простояли весь бой.
Теперь будет вопрос, будем ли мы следующий бой смотреть за дракой, либо мы следующий бой постоим, но потом будет.
Нам ничего не оставалось, кроме как дефить эту карту, потому что реально никак атаку без информации там не сделать.
Is this Himmelsdorf the basics, the back to basics that we expect to see from these two teams?
It's completely the standard lineups for this map, and as we saw in Ensk, it's the same lineup they took there. The triple 5100, it's a double IS3, and of course those two T1s making up the two tier points difference you need from the 5 tier 8 42.
Опять же, по истечению времени нашим двум танкам удалось убежать, и это стало ничьей.
Живем, Леша, уйти!
Дима, надо выживать, спокойно живем, окей.
Инспирование,
уезжайте,
Страйк уедет, Страйк уедет. 8 секунд left, power slide on.
Power slide has been spotted, but he needs to be in the scalp, he's done it! He could keep his team in this, if they stay alive, they will be going through to the next map.
Песчаная река впервые играется в формате 7.42. Тем более на таком серьезном турнире. Естественно, мы понимали, что наверняка будем на ней играть, и основательно к ней готовились.
Well, it is game time, ladies and gents. We are into the final battle between Virtus Pro and NAV.
Это самый быстрый сетап, который только можно взять. И мы активно перемещались по карте.
So NAV now have to hunker down and play the smart game here. 8 minutes and 45 seconds is the maximum time we'll have until we know who'll be walking away with that $60,000.
В какой-то момент мы перевернули карту, отдав свою базу и заняв корону. После этого мы просто динамически подсвечивали и перемещались по карте и планомерно, перезарядившись, раздавили оставшегося противника.
Врывайтесь, врывайтесь,
врывайтесь, врывайтесь, убивайте, я не успеваю.
Врывайтесь просто.
Я не смогу сбить. Пока Аня
тут
сбит.
Все окей.
As
vital as the next and fire! He takes him down, Kirill is most white! NAVI have done it! They've reclaimed the crown! They've shown exactly why they are at the top of this scene!
These were amazing, amazing 3 days. We have seen everything. We have seen action. We have seen some camping. We have seen emotions. We have seen passion. We have seen comebacks, legendary comebacks.
The World of Tanks first ever Grand Global Finals for the Wargaming.net League. On behalf of everyone here at the desk, on behalf of everyone from Poland and everyone that is a member of Turtle Entertainment, we thank you for tuning in. A huge thank you to our sponsors, Alienware, PayPal, Razer, the City of Warsaw, and Jinx. We'll see you next time. Good night and good game.